Hi, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are dealing with boring pixel sequences. But what's a pixel? A pixel is a picture element, the elementary component of an image. In our board, where Robi printer, our robot, moves and can decide whether to color or to skip a box, boxes are pixels, elementary picture elements, because they can only be colored entirely or sketched. In fact, we cannot ask Robi to make a drawing within a pixel inside a box, but just to make a drawing made of boxes. Okay? And since our Robi printer moves automatically across the board in this way, row by row, starting from this corner up here, we don't need to provide moving instructions to Robi. We just need to tell Robi whether to skip or to color a box when we know that it is on this box. Okay? So we need only two instructions apart from the one that Robi already knows for moving around. The first instruction is a skip, meaning that the box has not to be colored, or color, meaning that it has to color entirely the box where it is. Okay, so since we have only two instructions, we can encode these instructions in a fairly simple way using a binary digit. A binary digit is here represented by these tiles that are either gray, which means color, or white, which means don't color, skip. But we could also say that gray corresponds to 1 and white corresponds to 0. And in this case, we could have a sequence of bits. Okay. And we see all these instructions in sequence over there, just to make clear that once we know exactly the order in which our robot is visiting all the boxes, we can provide the entire sequence of instructions to be applied at each box without caring of the fact that at the end of a row the robot has to move to the beginning of the next one, because this will be done automatically. Okay, so let's see if these instructions are effective in making our robot draw something on the board. And I'll do it for the robot using this color here. So starting from here, we read color, color, skip, color, color. So color, color, skip, color, color. And at this point, we have color, 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 color. So, color, 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 and color. And then color, 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 color. Once again. And here I am. And now we have skip, color, 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 skip, skip, color, 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 skip, and then skip, skip, color, skip, skip. Skip, skip, color, skip, skip. You see, this sequence of bits represents this heart, which is made of very big pixels, our boxes on our board. But I'd like also to observe that we can take the first 5 bits and then the second 5 bits and put them in different rows in this way. And what happens is that by doing so, we end up building the same drawing that we wanted to encode. As you can see here, I'm building the same drawing that I have here. So this means that the instructions that I provided corresponds exactly to the pixels that I had to color or to scale. And when I decided to call this online lecture Boring Pixel Sequences, I had in mind these ones, the pixel sequences that are made of pixels all of the same kind, either colored or to be sketched. Because, as you can see here, if I wanted to pronounce the instructions and to provide the instructions to our robot here, I had to say color, color, skip, color, color, and then color, 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 and so on. And this is quite boring. So instead of saying so, I could take other small pieces of paper like this with numbers. And numbers can represent the repetitions of the same instruction, like in this case. So here, instead of saying color, color, skip, color, color, I could say twice color, skip, twice color. But then here, I could replace the entire row with this. Which means 5 times color, and then again 5 times color. Here it is. Let me take the proper one. Okay. And then here I have skip, and then 3 times color. And then skip, and here I have 2 times skip, then color, and 2 times skip. Okay, so these new instructions provide a much more efficient description of the same drawing. Let me double check that the drawing is exactly the same. So I take the marker and I have 2 times color, skip, color, color, and then 5 times color, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, again 5 times color, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then skip and color 3 times, and then skip, skip twice, and then color and skip twice. And here it is, our drawing. As you can see, this is the same heart that I had before. But all these tiles that I have saved are also bits that I could have saved in the description of this picture. And saving bits, which means having a much smaller description of the same drawing, is very important, because we always deal with digital pictures, with digital images that are, for instance, transmitted across the internet. And the time needed to transmit and receive them depends on the length of the description. So having saved bits means being able to transmit images in a shorter time, using less bandwidth, using less memory in our devices. Okay, this encoding is very similar to the one that is actually used by our computers to encode images, and it is called RAM length encoding, because it encodes sequences of bits specifying the number of bits in the sequence, which is called the length, while sequences of bits all of the same color are called RAM. These are not necessarily encoded by simple bits, because bits are sufficient as binary digits to encode either skip or color. But if we want also to have colorful images using many different colors, we need different words, not in the just bits, to specify which color we want in each box, in each pixel. Okay? But the principle is exactly the same. And I'd like to try to draw it again once more, but using an even smaller board, which is always 5x5, to show you the effect of having a much smaller board. So this is made of the same number of pixels, 25, but pixels are smaller. And as you can see, as the pixel gets smaller, then the image becomes better, and we appreciate this drawing here more than the other two, just because here we cannot recognize pixels, so it seems more like a true heart, for instance, drawn by hand rather than by big pixels as the first one. And if we have the three different boards here with the same drawing, it is like zooming in or zooming out, moving from this one to this one and vice versa. And this is something that you can always do with digital images. You can zoom in and then you will end up appreciating the size of pixel, or zoom out, and in this case you cannot recognize pixels. And in the digital images that we use on our computers and smartphones, we don't have just 25 pixels, but millions of them, making the images and the resolution of the images much better than in our fairly simple example. Bye-bye.